One question, friend. What in the fuck did I just watch?
Yeah, that's a good way to start here.
It came with, you know what?
That's a good way to start.
I got to watch this and not subscribe to Pornhub. It's cool. Cool.
Guys, today we are reviewing the drop on Netflix recently of Bastard, which is a recreation of a 80s era anime.
Really?
Yes. I think it was a manga from the 80s. If you haven't noticed, the main city is Metal Lucaria, which is meant to be Metallica. The main enemy is this demon that's in Anthraxis, I think is its name, which is Anthrax. And one of the spells used in the last episode, I think, was in reference to a band. I forget which band it was. But yes, this is very metal inspired.
Okay.
This is a dark metal fantasy.
No. You said that wrong. When you read the description of this show, it says heavy metal. And when I'm like, yeah. What?
Heavy metal, dark fantasy.
What so, am I supposed to expect from this?
Let's rewind a bit.
Yeah.
When we went into this, I had read a couple people's opinions on the recreation of the Bastard.
Mm.
And people said it is a dark fantasy akin to Berserk.
You mean like a 14-year-old boy that doesn't
not
understand
that.
His
I
body
just meant that, that
wrote an anime and just decided to be like, hey, let's make it popular where I make women wet constantly and I mental orgasms and I don't know. I don't know how I was supposed to take this.
No, so I was I had unrealistic expectations in when as if that's you good. Reference Bastard if you reference Bastard with Berserk, I'm going in with high expectations.
And I haven't watched Berserk yet. That is
spoiler
next on the
alert,
list.
It's coming.
It's coming soon.
We're going to do all three movies plus the anime that follows those. So stay tuned for that because I cannot wait.
Okay. I'm excited.
But I immediately was let down because Bastard to me was a boring Dragon Ball Z-esque fighter anime.
That's a loose fighter. Let's say
every episode was like a new monster or a new villain. And I thought the story was boring. I thought the animation was the best part of it, but that was about
how many villains had sex with him or wanted to? They fell in
they
love
wanted
with him.
To. You know,
only if I could
Dark
be so
Schneider.
Lucky to have sex with him.
Dark Schneider. If somebody said his name one more time, I was going to lose my mind. By the way, the
Dark
exposition
Schneider.
Dumps in this show are unbelievable. The last fight, so the last episode, Gaara, the guy who is the swordman, who was like narrating the fight
Which
scene between Dark Schneider
humorous.
And his disciple of 100 years. Every single thing they did was, now we're going to tell you about 30 seconds about the importance of what they're doing.
So you mean the
I
child
so
that Dark Schneider raised for 100 years and then just wanted to plow it so hard. By the end of meeting it, because the first thing he said when he saw her, wow, you've grown. I don't think breasts could get any bigger on
I
these
women.
I don't
know if another anime exists that is the embodiment of the phrase wish fulfillment, where you watch it and you want to escape to what your life could be if you were just more handsome and had more muscles.
And he liked to rub that in our faces too.
Yes.
Not handsome, not attractive. It's like, okay, great. Like, what am I supposed to get from this?
They are it
no
was
nipples.
Like, look,
no
I do,
bare ass. Nothing.
The outro was really good.
Oh,
the outro
music?
Song
oh,
was really.
You
good.
Know what?
Okay.
I'll say I've seen. You know, I've seen some, but I like this one because, and I think that's the only spot where we're like, oh, there's the heavy metal.
Yes, this is very much inspired by 80s heavy metal. Did you recognize, like a lot of the time, how whoever was speaking did like some grandiose, like orchestral. Ending of their sentence. I don't know how else to describe it. Where
Do you
they were
think
talking.
I was that engaged?
Well, there was like everyone who would speak would end in like this 80s themed scream.
I was just waiting for the next titty to drop. That's all I was
so
waiting for.
I was like prepared for that because I knew what where it came from.
And, like I couldn't
the
even,
influences mm. of this show. So that kind of made me, but I could not
okay.
care
okay.
very much about this show.
No, I thought like this reminded me of like, okay, and I loved it. I loved He-Man's revival. I did, and that was an 80s. So
the Masters of the Universe
yes.
one? Yeah.
So since you're, that we did review, but now you're telling me, explaining this to me, now it makes sense. It's reviving something from the 80s
mm-hmm.
that probably had no sense or like you know, nothing to it then, and now you put it moving on and expect traction. Yeah. And my guess is, so the best parts of the show. There is a best part of a pile of garbage, you know.
I didn't think it was a pile of garbage though. So I thought it was just at the very best, I would call this a passable fighting boss anime.
And do you know the best fight scenes and the best story, I'll say, because the irrelevant, was when Dark Schneider was not even there.
Yeah, the
and I appreciated the fight scenes between like Gaara and the his 100-year love child of
if I had to watch,
will you condition one more. You groom somebody to be your lover, and you just, there's so much here that I just don't understand.
If I had to watch one more fake death illusion, or for the fuck's sake, suck the poison out, I literally was going to lose my mind.
And honestly, it was very PG where the poison got. Angles are key in this show. If you ever want to see a defeated Dark Schneider, you got to look at a sweet pair of ass cheeks right before you see him, because the women... there was a part, and I'm not ruining this for anybody. Please watch the sex episode that you want to do. But
and it's not really. It's like what TVMA would be if they want kids to be able to watch it.
There were no nipples. And that's all I wanted.
Okay. Yeah.
You know, because what would have made this show a little bit better was a little nip slip, a little of this, a little of that. But whatever, you know.
This show was wish fulfillment from a 14-year-old's perspective.
Yeah. Oh, here's a strong woman, a princess, going to take her armor into battle. You're slowing me down. Take your armor off. Huh? Okay, cool. Now she's in heavy armor in any game we've ever played. So that is just two chips covering her titties and nothing.
That's it.
You know, it's heavy armor. And then you're still slowing it. Now we got to throw her on her shoulder and rubber at the same time. It's fucking wild.
Yeah, no, this was not what I wanted it to be. But you know what? I just kind of turned my brain off and was like, show me good action scenes. And there were some good action scenes. And
very, very minimal.
There were some good fights, and that was why we're going to get into the
Ninja
review.
Masters were great.
Yeah, that was probably one of the best episodes, too. Those two or three
until
episodes.
Until he started narrating Gaara every breath of the Kamehameha and the spirit bombs come in and whatever I was watching.
Let's get into the Layman's review. And we're going to do a 3, 2, 1.
Oh, God. Sorry, buddy. Sorry. That's not a letter, everybody. That's not a letter. D. Hard D. Hard D.
I gave it a C because I kind of enjoyed the fight scenes. I kind of enjoyed the animation. And outside of that, I didn't really have much for this. I did not care about a single character. I did not care about Dark Schneider's, like, reincarnation as a better soul.
They made 15 years seem like it was a long time.
Yeah.
That was like yesterday.
I didn't buy the reincarnation, like the little boy who he was.
Lucius.
Lucius.
You know, the one that the girl was in love with because she loved the boy.
Yeah.
The others loved the man, so she was going
to. I don't know how that's supposed to work.
And there was only two virgins in the entire city, the princess and his helper that the priest said, that's probably one of the few children that the priest didn't touch. And made her stay his keeper and be the virgin for him to make out with the small child.
I'm gonna
to bring him out, and then he saves the earth, and then he got to go back as a kid. And
look, I'm gonna give you one and just say, because it was a scene, it was just like I literally just wanted to get through it because we were reviewing it. I'll side with you on D.
It got a D and ready. This was it. I think it was episode 6 or 7. I get them confused with the amount of women in the same story. That was every episode.
Yeah.
It's the same thing, just on repeat. But I was going to stop watching it and just come to this review and act like I watched the whole thing. Cause I did because they were the same story every episode 6. And I was just like, okay. And you know, I was watching this. I'm like, this could be kind of uncomfortable if I was like any cleaner of mind or younger.
Yeah.
I was watching this because I've watched some things and I've seen things, and this happened to be one that's like, and then Ryan gives it to me to watch. I don't know what he was trying to do. Imagine if we watched it together. By the end of it, we're nude and somebody's getting touched. I don't know. I don't know. There's a season 2, I'm assuming.
You know what? No, there's a second part to season 1. It's 11 more episodes.
Oh, God.
Yeah. My favorite part about the whole season, though, was the swords and the spirits that were in the swords. So,
Ifrit
was in the sword, and then there was the one thunder.
Yeah, lightning god, thunder god.
New.
I don't
know. That was the best part.
And Honestly, I probably didn't realize any of that because every time
I was like, "Why can't you make an anime about like the demons in the swords and make the swords basically the protagonists?"
But he didn't need that sword. You know, I talked to somebody about the show. He just throws up gang signs and people disappear. That's it.
Well, guys, that was our Layman's review of Anime Bastard. On Netflix. Check it out if you haven't.
13 episodes, man. 20 minutes.
If you're into softcore anime porn, this is right up your alley and absolutely zero substance behind the characters or the plot. And my God, can I just say before we close, Metal Lucaria, the city, the most useless soldiers I've ever seen in my life. If they didn't get saved every episode, that kingdom did not deserve to be there.
Whenever you needed them, Dark Schneider came to your rescue from towns away.
Guys, let us know what you think. Are we off base here? Did you like Bastard more than we did?
Explain it to me.
Let us know in the comments below, and we will see you on the next video.